En mi casa, soy la directora de comunicaciones del Distrito Escolar de Arlington. My name is Amy Casas. I'm the Director of Communications for the Arlington School District. And I would like to thank you for coming out to this very important family event tonight. Quisiera darle las gracias de asistir a este evento familiar muy importante, ya que vamos a estar hablando de un tema que es algo muy importante para un distrito escolar, que es cómo involucrar a las familias. We're going to be talking about a very important topic tonight, which is family involvement and the importance of family involvement in a child's life and why that's important. Before we begin, I would like to give special thanks to Sam Houston High School for hosting the event this evening. Especially to Principal Fernando Benavides, Assistant Principal Kathy Britton, Family School Representative Roslyn Birch, Project SOAR Campus Coordinator Athena Daniels, and all the Sam Houston staff, because I know a lot of them have worked to make this event possible. So estaba introduciendo al personal de Sam Houston y dándole las gracias a la escuela Sam Houston por tener este evento en su escuela, ya que ellos organizaron este evento y les estaba dando las gracias. I would also like to thank the Texas Rangers Baseball Foundation for facilitating the participation of the players, broadcasters, and Rangers captain. También quisiera agradecer a la Fundación de Béisbol de los Rangers por facilitar la participación de sus jugadores, de las personalidades de radio y también de su mascota Rangers Captain, que va a estar disponible en unos momentos para tomarse fotos con los niños en la cafetería. Rangers Captain will also be available for photo opportunities for the little ones. So if you have a child and you would like them to get a picture with Rangers Captain, he is going to be available over there in the cafeteria. Right now, I would like to introduce our AISD superintendent, Dr. Marcelo Cavazos, who is going to give a welcome. Ahorita quisiera introducir al superintendente del Distrito Escolar de Arlington, el Dr. Marcelo Cavazos.
Thank you. Muchas gracias y bienvenidos a todos. Thank you and welcome to each and every one of you. Es un placer de estar aquí como su superintendente de las escuelas de Arlington. It's my pleasure to be here as your superintendent for the Arlington Independent School District. Este evento es muy importante porque queremos platicar sobre temas de involucrar a los padres. This tonight is really important because we want to talk about how we engage parents. Y involucrar a los padres para que sus hijos tengan éxito en las escuelas. Involve parents so that your kids and your children can have success in our schools. Porque es muy importante que piensemos del futuro. It's very important that we think about the future. Que cuando estamos laborando en las clases, that when the kids are in class y están haciendo su tarea y su trabajo, when they're doing their work and their homework, that they're always thinking of their future, que están pensando de su futuro. Porque cuando pensamos de nuestro futuro, nos da mucha esperanza. When we think about our future, it gives us great hope. And so tonight is a demonstration of that. Hoy, esta noche, es algo que nosotros pensamos que es muy importante. Porque el futuro es juntos. El futuro es todos. We're all part of the future of our kids. No nada más los estudiantes, todos tenemos responsabilidad. We all have a responsibility to make sure our kids are educated. So, yo he dicho esto muchas veces, que los deseos que tengo yo para mis hijos, y tengo dos en las escuelas del distrito, los tengo para todos los estudiantes del distrito. The same dreams and aspirations I have for my two kids in school, I have for every student in our school district. So, bienvenidos. Y ojalá que se diviertan, que aprendan algo de involucrarse en las escuelas. I hope you learn something tonight and you engage with us in helping us have your children have some success. So, quiero presentar y dar las gracias a Karen Morris. Karen Morris is from the Texas Rangers. I'm going to say something. Y hace in June, Karen and I, we spoke about having an event like this. En junio, Karen y yo platicamos de tener un evento así para ayudarle a los padres y para dar información de cómo pueden tener éxito sus hijos. So we spoke about how we could have an event to bring the community with the Texas Rangers. So Karen, muchas gracias, se lo agradezco. I really appreciate it. So this is Karen Morris.
Hi, I am so happy to be here and so proud to be a part of the Texas Rangers organization. My name is Karen Morris. I'm the executive director of the Texas Rangers Baseball Foundation, and I'm also the vice president of community outreach. And I also have two of my staff with me here tonight, Lauren Pesqueda and Monique Corrales. And the three of us feel like we have the best job second to playing baseball. We get to work with all of you. Y somos muy orgullosos de estar aquí esta noche. La comunidad de Arlington es nuestro corazón y el futuro de los niños es muy importante para nosotros porque es el futuro de los Rangers. Porque algún día ustedes van a ser nuestros empleados, nuestros jugadores y más. Y por eso nosotros estamos aquí esta noche para hablar sobre el futuro de nuestros estudiantes. So thank you so much for having us. We look forward to hearing and seeing your children be the future of Arlington. But you don't want to hear from me.
So, muchas gracias, Karen. Okay. Permíteme que haga una introducción, okay? I permit me to do one introduction. So, quiero dar las gracias al principal de Workman Junior High Principal, Kelvin Stroy. OJ Kemp, Athletic Director for Arlington ISD. OJ. Electra Kitchen. From our dropout prevention office. Thank you, Electra. And very important, our board vice president, Mr. Bowie Hogg. De la mesa directiva del distrito de Arlington, Mr. Bowie Hogg. So muchas gracias. Thank you all for coming.
Okay, well, and like I said, I know that I might think I'm a nice person, but you probably don't want to hear from me all night, so I'm going to introduce someone that I hope you are all familiar with. His name is Elena Ornelas. He joined the Rangers officially when I did back in 2003. You can hear him every game on ESPN Deportes 1540 AM or on the SAT button on Fox Sports Southwest or TXA21. So I'd like to bring out Elena.
Thank you very much. Good evening. Good evening. I can hear you. Let me hear you. Good evening. Good evening. We've been in schools all day, and we're not tired. So I hope that you're not tired to listen to us, because we're going to be talking a lot. So let me hear you again one more time. Good evening.
Good evening.
All right. That makes me feel better. I'm going to introduce my the players for the Texas Rangers. I'm the play-by-play guy announcer in Spanish for the Texas Rangers since 2000. In 2003, I was employed full-time for the Texas Rangers. I enjoy this job, not only broadcasting the games, also, you know, doing these events with the community, because that's what the players like to do also. So that's why I'm not taking out more time and introduce my partners over there. Angel Beltré from the Dominican Republic, Joaquin Soria, and Benji Hill. Oh, no, sit. Come on. If you have any questions, there'll be time for questions for any one of us, of course, after everybody is going to have a little brief message from ourselves to all of you parents and students that are here tonight. Vamos a dar un mensaje para todos los padres de familia, para los alumnos que están aquí esta noche en este auditorio. Ya, yo tuve el gusto de venir aquí el año pasado. Estuvimos con un grupo selecto de estudiantes, recuerdo, estábamos sentados aquí con Luis Martínez, un catcher que tenía el equipo de los Texas Rangers. Así que este es un honor, de veras, un gusto para mí, de estar aquí con ustedes, de invitado, con mis compañeros Angel Beltré, Joaquín Soria y Benji Hill, que será mi compañero en las transmisiones en esta temporada. Para que ustedes, si tienen preguntas, las pueden hacer al término de la introducción de cada uno de ellos, que cuenten una anécdota personal o algo que quieran compartir con ustedes, y habrá tiempo para preguntas. Por esa razón, para eso estamos aquí con ustedes, para atenderlos, y por supuesto que se pasen un buen rato, que no se cansen de escucharnos o de hablar. Pueden, por supuesto, preguntar al momento que ustedes quieran, cuando ellos estén hablando, cada uno de ellos. Así que, well, thank you very much. As I say, I'm very pleased to be here, and you have time for questions with every one of us, and they will share sometimes with you, and when you have questions, please raise your hand, and we'll follow that. Así que, they have a microphone over there. They're telling me there's a microphone down there. So thank you very much again for inviting us. I'm from Mexico. Soy de Ciudad Juárez, Chihuahua, México. No sé. Hay paisanos por aquí. Qué bueno. Y se siente bien a gusto luego. Y hasta se me olvidó el inglés. I forgot English already. No. No, sí, paisanos, bueno, para toda la gente de México. ¿Cuánta gente hay de México por aquí? A ver, ¿dónde está la gente de México? A ver, un grito como mexicanos. Es todo, sí se oye, sí se oye. Eso es para entrar en ambiente porque está un poquito frío, no estamos esperando que llegáramos aquí con ustedes. Así que, sí, yo tengo ya 10 años trabajando oficialmente para el equipo de tiempo completo. Esta será mi temporada número 14, que soy parte de los Texas Rangers, así que un honor para mí ser mexicano y formar parte de esta franquicia que en las últimas 3 temporadas hay 2 veces a la Serie Mundial y la última un juego de playoff todavía aquí en este parque de pelota de Arlington. Y vamos a ver qué es lo que pasa en esta temporada que entra en el 2013, que ya empieza en el próximo mes de marzo y abril para ustedes aquí en el área de Arlington, que son afortunados en tener este equipo que ahorita es una de las mejores franquicias en el béisbol, en las grandes ligas, por supuesto. I'm very proud to be working for Texas Rangers. As I told you, this is my 10th full season, but 14, it will be my 14th season with the Rangers doing play-by-play with the team. And of course, I'm very honored to be part of this organization that has won two World Series twice in the last 3 years. And last year also, 3 years in a row went to the playoffs. So I'm very proud to be part of that. Of course, to have this opportunity to talk to all of you here tonight. I want to introduce one of the guys that I think is going to speak more Spanish than English from the Dominican Republic. He was the best player in the minor leagues for the Rangers, Angel Beltré from Santo Domingo in La República Dominicana.
Good evening, good evening. Buena, buena, ¿cómo están? Soy Angel Beltré de Dominicana. Juego para los Texas Rangers y nada, estamos aquí para dar ejemplo y de como somos profesional. Y también yo me recuerdo que cuando yo estaba sentado ahí con ustedes, yo pensaba, ¿cuándo yo voy a estar en algo profesional? Cuando yo siempre me puse algo en la mente, siempre me puse una meta y me dije, yo mismo me dije, yo quiero ser algo en el futuro y quiero ser alguien cuando mi familia diga, mira, es un ejemplo de la familia. Y yo creo que antes, cuando yo estaba en la escuela, nunca me gustaba hacer la tarea, nunca, nunca, nunca. Y mi mamá me decía, no, yo quiero que tú seas algo importante en cuando tú seas grande. Yo creo que tú te pongas a estudiar y también por la pelota. Siempre dormía con un guante y un bate. Y yo dije, algo yo voy a sacar de esta pelota, y siempre puse el esfuerzo, siempre puse algo en mi camino. Y yo creo que es muy importante que los padres de uno le enseñen la educación desde chiquito, desde pequeño, y que tengan una base, porque es muy importante cuando uno está ya a una cierta edad, cuando esté grande, algo le va a faltar. Y si uno desde pequeño se pone en una meta y con la educación como debe ser, que de su padre le den a uno, yo creo que no le va a faltar nada cuando estemos grandes. I was telling in Spanish that I'm from Dominican Republic, Santo Domingo, and I usually don't like to do homework, and my mom telling me, you gotta do it, cause I want you to be somebody in the future. I want you to be not really professional baseball player, but somebody. So when the family see you, be an example or leader of the family. And I'm telling myself, I put a goal and a dream, so I can do my homework. So I can put all the things together and trying to be what I am now. And like I say, it's special for me to be a professional, the only professional baseball player in my family. And when you put a goal, when you set a goal in yourself, you gotta go through your goal and you gotta work hard, you gotta put everything that you can. So you can be somebody in the future, and for the parents, you gotta always tell your son, your kid, that stay out of trouble, that is very important so you can do all the stuff in school, be a told him to be a leader, told him to be a sample in the class, and thank you.
Not easy to be. Thank you, Angel. It's one question for you before you take your seat. It's not easy. How hard was for you when you have 14, 15, 16 years old, when you have the guys, your friends from that doesn't like to go to school, and you had to stay in the right track, and your parents pulling one side and your friends pulling the other side. You had to have good friends, and it's nothing that people cannot come back to the right track, because sometimes you go to the wrong way and come back to the right track, but that's the most hard thing to do. What happened to you when you were that age?
It happened to me, and that really happened when I was 14, 15, and my friend telling me, let's go out and let's call class. I remember in high school, my period was like in the three first class, and after that, I couldn't go out in the street and hanging around with them. But I always remember what my mom telling me. My mom told me, you gotta be somebody, you gotta go to school,
You gotta stay focused.
You gotta especially respect your family when you're in the school and trying to do all the things or trying to be an example for your student, you and your teacher.
Okay, thank you very much, Angel. Now, this is a new player for the Rangers. He was signed about 2 weeks, well, 3 weeks ago. About 3 weeks ago, and he played his major league career with the Kansas City Royals, and he was the closer for them. He's now part of the Rangers, and he'll be helping the Rangers in this 2013 season, coming in March, in April, and he is recovering from a surgery. He's from Monclova, Coahuila, Mexico. Joaquín Soria.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Joaquín Soria, soy, como dijo aquí mi compañero, soy de Monclova, Coahuila, México, y ahora estamos en nuestra nueva etapa con los Texas Rangers. Mis seis años pasados estuve con Kansas City Royals, estuve desarrollando el rol de cerrador, y gracias a Dios tuve una bonita carrera ya, pero ahora es una nueva página en mi carrera, que estamos aquí ahora con los Texas Rangers. Y de las cosas que veníamos aquí nosotros a hablarles a ustedes es de la importancia de lo que es la familia en nuestras vidas, ¿no? Y para mí la importancia que tuvo mi familia, lo que todo lo que yo he hecho no había sido sin el respaldo de mi familia. Mi padre fue mi primer coach, mi mentor, y mi madre siempre apoyándonos, ¿no? Entonces me da mucho gusto ver aquí a muchos padres de familia que vienen a apoyar a sus hijos, porque yo siempre he tenido bien presente en mi mente de que lo más importante en la vida es la familia, ¿no? Y lo que el legado que nos dejan nuestros padres es nuestros estudios. Es los estudios, la preparación y el futuro que nos dan va a ser a base de nuestros estudios. Me da mucho gusto que nos hayan invitado aquí para hablar con ustedes, y muchas gracias por estos minutos que nos dejan a nosotros para hablarles. My name is Joaquín Soria. I'm from Monclova, Mexico. I'm really glad to be here. The past six years, I was with the Kansas City Royals. I was with them for the 6 years, and those 6 years, I glad they joined to be two times All-Star, and this is a really good feeling for me. Now with the Texas Rangers, I want to try to help them to win the World Series. That's one of my purpose. Right now, I'm recovering from the Tommy John surgery. This is my second one. And what I would say in Spanish is that one of the most important things in life is family. And without my family, I can be nobody. And I'm glad to see a lot of families in here supporting your kids. That's amazing, because that's a legacy that you're going to give it to them. Because without the family, we're nobody. I'm really glad to see you guys in here, and I hope you guys support your kids like I will do with my son, with my two kids. And now that I'm a father, I know the responsibilities to be a father, and it's really hard. It's really hard, seriously. I mean, and he's only 3 years old and a 2 months old. and it's really hard, and I wanna be the best parent for them, so they can that's the legacy that I'm gonna give it to them. So I'm really glad that you guys, I see a lot of families in here, keep that up and support you guys. Thank you.
Well, maybe most of you already met my partner because he was signing autographs and taking pictures with everybody before we came here. And he used to play for the Texas Rangers. He was drafted by the Texas Rangers. And he won a World Series ring with the Anaheim Angels. And he is now with the Texas Rangers, so he's part of the team. And he's going to be my partner. He's going to be my color commentator on the broadcast in Spanish. As Kevin told you, we'll broadcast the games on 15:40 a.m. on ESPN Deportes. 15:40 ESPN Deportes, o si no, en el SAP. Si tienen televisiones de las buenas, que no sean de leña, las televisiones buenas que agarran el SAP, ahí lo pueden escuchar. Así que, you have the SAP, you have the option for the SAP to listen in Spanish to us, just in case you want to listen to Benji Hill, that is going to be my partner. This is going to be his first season with the Texas Rangers as a color commentator. Así que, Benji, de Tijuana, California, México.
Buenas noches, good evening. Primeramente, quiero agradecerles a todo el mundo por la oportunidad de venir y convivir con ustedes. A lo mejor platicarles un poquito de lo que fue mi carrera y convivir con ustedes, dar nuestras opiniones. De cualquier manera que podamos ayudar, estamos únicamente aquí para eso el día de hoy o esta noche. Como han comentado los otros muchachos, es de la importancia, creo, de la familia. Son lo fundamental, creo, en la vida de nuestros hijos, la educación que les podemos dar en casa, y pedirles exigir el esfuerzo que ellos pongan también, no solo en la educación en su casa, pero también en los estudios. Creo que son dos fundamentos que son extremadamente importantes, en los cuales los van a llevar a un buen camino y darles tremendas oportunidades en la vida, sea en cualquier avenida que puedan elegir ellos, ya sea en deporte, en algún tipo de profesión que puedan elegir. Eso siempre va a ser parte importante. Y yo como padre de familia, igual, tengo dos hijos, yo le pido algunas cosas a mis hijos, no solo es a educarlos, yo a ellos les pido de que sueñen a lo grande. De la única manera que uno puede llegar a tener algún tipo de grandeza en su vida es primeramente soñándolo, poniéndose las metas de poder llegar a alcanzar esos sueños. Si uno no sueña lo grande, es muy difícil lograr grandeza. Entonces, a los padres de familia, a los maestros, les pido que por favor denles a estos muchachos un empujón para que sí sueñen lo grande y puedan ellos de allí agarrar ellos su propio camino para así proponerse la grandeza que ellos buscan en esta vida. I just am thankful to be here. It's a pleasure. I think one of the greatest things that opportunities that we get as professional athletes is to give back, to share our experiences, maybe a message. And if there's a few people, a few kids that we can help guide in the right direction, it's all worth it. So on behalf of the Rangers and the rest of the guys, in my opinion, like Joaquin said, I'm also a father. I know it's not easy. Trust me, my kids make it a lot harder, I think, than most. But, you know, it's a challenge. But like Joaquin said, and I think like most of you would probably agree, it's a great challenge, but it's a beautiful challenge. It's probably one of the best experiences. I know I'm thankful for my career, but to this date, the best job I've ever had is being a father and being there for my family. But I ask you parents, please help guide, not just by being helping them be good kids at home, with teaching them manners, ask, require the kids to give a good effort in their schoolwork and to dream big. In order to achieve greatness in life, I believe you have to. You absolutely have got to dream big. If you do not dream big, it's hard to achieve greatness. You just kind of go through the motions, and you, it's hard to achieve greatness unless you dream big. So ask, and teachers as well, and counselors and administrators, really push the kids to dream big. Because if they set it in their minds and they have the passion, sometimes we just got to push them along and get it out of them. If they dream big and they have passion and they have the work ethic, I believe that anything can be achieved in this world. Everybody has speed bumps and some difficult roads along the way, as I'm sure that you guys will have some questions and we'll be able to share with you guys. But if you have passion and you have goals and you have dreams and you're not scared to go after those dreams, anything can be achieved in this world. So thank you for having us, and it's a pleasure to be here.
Now it's time for questions. The microphone is right there with Elvis Andros, with the guy that has the Ranger shirt. Yeah. Preguntas, levante su mano, por favor. Questions, raise your hand. It's a microphone on this side. Nobody? Come on, parents. Acá está uno. Enfrente. No tengan miedo, por favor. Por favor, toda la raza hispana, no tengan miedo de hacer preguntas, ¿eh? ¿Verdad? Son gratis las preguntas, dijo Benji, son gratis, ok. Questions are free, ok.
Hi, I'm Kedron Davis. I'm the head baseball coach here at Sam Houston High School. I felt the need to take this opportunity to tell you guys that I implement my baseball program much like the Texas Rangers. From the top down, how we practice, how we do everything. So I just want to give you guys kudos for that. But my question to you is that I have a majority of my varsity baseball kids in here, and they think I'm the meanest person in the world. But I'm trying to tell them that to get to you guys' level, there's a certain amount of work ethic, there's a certain mentality that you must have that separates you from everybody else. Could you take that time to maybe in a few minutes explain that to them?
You say it right. I mean, to get to this level, first of all, you have to make sacrifices. If you don't make sacrifices, you don't go anywhere. I mean, there is a lot of distractions in the way. And if you take those distractions, you're never going to make it. And it's the same thing in other things in life and in other careers. If you want to be a doctor, be the best doctor ever. If you want to be a professional baseball player, so be one. Be there, be at the field, do your conditionings without complaining, do everything. Because I think that's the
no
most
complaints.
Important thing. That's the most important thing. You don't have to go to the other lines.
First of all, you guys must have a good team because you got a big applause. You must be a good coach. Okay. I'll tell you what, I help coach my son's team. They're 12 years old, and they sometimes don't see me as a professional baseball player, but when I'm around my friends, then they're in awe. And the one thing I tell the guys, the kids and any kids that I'm ever around is, and I guess maybe I'm talking to the kids that are on the baseball team and in other sports right now. To get to the big leagues, there are no lazy players. It's impossible. And if you go on to be an all-star like he was, or has been, and will be again, Hall of Famers, there are no lazy Hall of Famers in any Hall of Fame. There are no lazy Major League players. And if there are, they don't last. I think we were asked today at a school, if it was harder to stay in the big leagues than it was to get there. It is very difficult to get to the big leagues. It's extremely hard to establish yourself in the major leagues because you have guys trying to take your job every single year. There's a number one draft pick for each team every year. There's top prospects every year. So you have to have the responsibility to, every time you go to the gym, you got to give your best effort. Every time you go to practice, give your best effort. Another thing that, and this pertains to probably all walks of life, all work, if you're coachable, that means you're a hard worker. If you work at a supermarket and you don't do your best, it's like the same type of thing. You're not a hard worker, you're not gonna get the benefit of the doubt. So whatever it is that the coach asks you to do, bite your tongue if you have to, do your best, and then see, I guarantee you, the coaches will appreciate your efforts.
Quiero hacerles una pregunta. ¿Qué opinan ustedes cuando algunos niños solo se enfocan en que van a ser jugadores, pero no estudian? Dicen, no, muchos son jugadores reconocidos, mas no terminaron la escuela. Quiero escuchar su respuesta.
The question is, what is their opinion about students that say, I'm going to be a professional player, and they don't like to finish school, or because there are some famous athletes that never finish school and they are big stars. So it's, that was a question.
Con la pregunta, yo creo que esos niños que apelan a eso y no estudian, yo creo que si no tienen una educación desde el principio, desde que nacen, yo creo que nunca van a llegar a una meta o algo importante como profesional. Yo creo que por primordial hay que estudiar. Eso es lo que de que uno nace, de que uno es chiquito, lo enseñan mi mamá, los maestros, todo el mundo a estudiar y a tratar de tener una educación correcta. Porque si yo creo que aquí en esta pelota profesional, si tú no tienes una educación, si tú no tienes una base, los dos primeros años yo creo que te echan para afuera. Yo creo que es importante tener la educación y yo creo que algo que tiene que siempre llevarse de su mamá, su maestro, y de eso se basa esa pregunta.
Bueno, pues primeramente aquí en Estados Unidos, para poder ser drafteados en un equipo profesional, pues tienen que primero corresponder a la escuela, ¿no? Si no, pues no hay nada. Ustedes que están aquí tienen muchas oportunidades con los college y todo eso, pero tienen que demostrarle al colegio que ustedes también pueden ser primero estudiantes para después ser deportistas. Entonces, es tan importante el estudio como el deporte. No significa que no pueden ir los dos juntos, porque se pueden hacer las dos cosas. Simplemente hay que esforzarse bastante, hay que poner mucha dedicación a las dos cosas. Y si tan importante como es para los padres que saquen una buena calificación, para el coach es que tengan un buen rendimiento en el terreno, entonces tienen que dedicarle el mismo tiempo a las dos cosas para poder sobresalir e inclusive para poder desarrollarse en el ámbito social, porque si nosotros no tuviéramos educación, ¿de qué manera podríamos hablarles a ustedes? ¿De qué manera podríamos ser un ejemplo para las personas o ser unos líderes en lo que nosotros hacemos? Tenemos que primero estar preparados.
En inglés, por favor.
The question was you already said the question, right? I said that is important to be a good student, that be a good sport. Because you guys in here, in the college and stuff, in order to be a professional player, to be drafted, you have to first be a student and be a good one. Because if not, they take you out of the teams, and that's the way it rolls here. So It is really important to be a really good student because that way you can handle every single situation, like talking to people. So you can be an example for everybody, be a good leader, and because the people respect you more when you're educated, when you had studies and when you had everything in your life, sports and student, it can be combined because you have to put the same effort in both in order to be a professional.
Primeramente quisiera saludar y felicitar al señor Joaquín Soria. Mi familia, nosotros somos de Monclova, Coahuila. No tenía yo el gusto de conocerlo personalmente, pero sí lo conocía por mi padre, que le gusta mucho el béisbol. Y nos da mucho gusto que ahora esté aquí en Arlington y que pertenezca ahora a los Texas Rangers. Y la pregunta es, he escuchado comentarios generalmente que los niños son niños, que hay una etapa donde los niños pues tienen que preocuparse solamente por jugar, por divertirse, que no robemos esa niñez. Y la pregunta es si hay una edad o hay un tiempo donde el niño tiene que tomar más responsabilidades o empezar a ser maduro para poder elegir su futuro. Gracias.
Gusto en saludarla y gracias, orgullosamente monclovense y mexicano ante todo, ¿no? Pues mira, en mi caso yo pues, siempre fui un niño muy hiperactivo, ¿no? No me aguantaba en la casa, yo creo que por eso mis papás me pusieron a jugar, porque no me aguantaba en la casa, destruía cosas y todo y siempre jugando, ¿no? Pero la parte importante y la madurez que tienen los hijos viene desde la educación que le dan los padres. Ellos van a madurar de acuerdo a la exigencia que usted le dé. Si usted lo hace responsable, si usted lo hace a que tienda su cama, a que haga todas las cosas en la casa, lo ayude, eso lo va a hacer responsable porque eso es parte de la educación y de la responsabilidad que le van a hacer a sus hijos. En mi caso, mis padres siempre nos enseñaron la educación de ayudar y eso al momento de ayudar tú estás siendo maduro. ¿Por qué? Porque tienes el instinto de ayudar a las demás personas, porque tienes la responsabilidad con tu familia primeramente de ser un buen hijo para poder ser un ser humano.
Gracias en inglés. Y di la pregunta. The question was, what is the best time or the time, the right time or the right moment in the childhood to tell them to grow up and be responsible? Because they say always, they look like, no, we're kids, just leave us alone, stuff like that. So that was the question.
Well, in my personal life, I was a hyper kid all the time. I destroyed things in my house, and I think that's one of the main reasons they put me in the baseball, because they can handle me in the house. So, and one of the things that I say about being responsible is the education that we give our kids. Since the first, they make responsible persons. If you put your kid to fix the bed or to wash the dishes or whatever, that kind of thing make them responsible for themselves, and to help the other people, it make you the biggest thing. I think the biggest thing ever is to help other people, and helping the other people it make you more responsible, because you first be, if you're good with the family, you can be good with other people too. So that the thing is, there is not a specific age to be responsible. They can be responsible since the first.
Sí, como dice Joaquín, el ser responsable, no, en realidad no creo que tenga haya un número, una edad. Obvio que hay niños que maduran un poquito más rápido que otros, pero creo que las enseñanzas de uno como padre de familia, el enseñarles sí algo de responsabilidad y respeto a no nomás a los padres de familia, pero tanto en la escuela, a sus compañeros, a esa educación y enseñarles ese tipo de respeto, pues no nomás los va a llevar a alturas dentro de su profesión o su carrera en algunos casos como atletas, pero los va a ayudar a ser buenos seres humanos y van a ser unos buenos elementos siempre a la comunidad. Entonces, no creo que haya una edad, y creo que, como dicen, ¿no?, en veces el comentario que hicieron de que, pues dejarlos jugar. Sí, claro, nunca quitarles de la mente el jugar y divertirse, porque para eso inventaron este deporte, es para ir a pasar un buen rato entre amigos y disfrutar del juego. Sí es un juego y siempre va a ser un juego, pero creo que es porque es un juego y porque es un juego que una diversión para los niños, también nos da la oportunidad de exigirles a ellos que sí sean responsables, que sean respetuosos y que sean responsables a lo mejor con sus estudios o sus quehaceres en la casa. Y creo que a lo mejor hasta usar el deporte para exigirles a ellos esas responsabilidades.
Briefly in English.
In English, as Joaquin was saying, for them to be responsible, for kids to be responsible, I don't think there's an age, and I understand that there's kids that mature quicker than others, and there are kids that are very hyper. But I think to teach them to be responsible, to be respectful, I think that's huge as parents, and I think it's our responsibility as parents to require that from them. It's not something that they maybe should do. I think it's something that as parents we should require and ask and maybe mandate that they do have respect, that they respect not only us as parents, respect their teachers, respect their classmates, their peers. For one, it'll if we can teach them to be respectful and to be responsible in their daily life, it doesn't mean that they don't let them enjoy or make it seem like they shouldn't enjoy the game. When it's all said and done, the game was invented as a detraction from work and from other things. It wasn't meant to be. When baseball was invented, it wasn't invented for it to be a career. It was for people to go and almost like a hobby, just people to get away from work and just go enjoy themselves and get away from the stresses of life. So, yes, absolutely, let them have fun, but that responsibility and respect that we ask of them and that we should require, I think, of them, if anything, I think we use sports as a tool to sometimes request our children to do those things, to be responsible, to be respectful, to be a good Samaritan, to be a good human being, to be a good classmate, to be a good student. And if they're not, us as parents, not just leave it up to the schools and the administrators to say, if your grades aren't up, then you can't play. Us as parents say, hey, well, I'm glad your grades are up, but if you're being disrespectful to me at home or to your siblings, then you can't play. So I think we can use it as a tool. And when it's all said and done, if we're able to have a few kids come out of this high school and be major leaguers, great. But if we're able to have every team or this team, and all of a sudden we throw them out into the world and they're all good human beings, I think that's a lot better.
One last question.
I just want to know, because I don't know if y'all went to college or finished college, but I do tell both my boys that that's what I would like for them to do versus just being like most players, they get drafted directly after high school, they just go. I want them to know that there is something else to fall back on if they don't make it, and if y'all have ever gone.
Personally, I did not go to college. I signed a letter of intent to go to the University of Miami. Even though I was born in Tijuana, Mexico, I grew up pretty much on both sides of the border, but I always did all my schooling all the way from kindergarten through high school in San Diego. I signed my letter of intent. I was excited to go to college. Fortunately for me, I was drafted in the first round and was made an offer that I couldn't turn down. And it enabled me to go to begin my professional career. But I will say this, and to be completely honest with you, it wasn't something that I requested in my contract, but it was something that was requested by my parents in my contract, that if anything happened to me, my education is paid for if I were to go back. Fortunately, I was able to have a lengthy career, but it was a safety net. And I think if you're not a good student, you don't even have that. So fortunately, I was able to hang around for a while to where I didn't go back and use that safety net. But you never know as an athlete. You know, I had, you know, like Joaquin here to my left, he's had two surgeries. As you hear him talk, you know he's a well-educated human being. I had back surgery when I was 22. Fortunately, I was able to recover from that, but I promise you that if I had not recovered from that back surgery, I would have been at the University of Miami and trying to get a degree so that I would have a chance to be successful in life.
Well, as you know, I'm from Mexico, and the things over there are way different than here. And when I was like 15 years old, there was a scout coming out to my house and asked me to sign with the team, Mexican team. And my dad, all my family, they graduated from college. My older brother, he's a dentist and a math teacher. My sister is an engineer and a math teacher. My other sister is a dentist. So all my family graduated from college. And it was hard for me, I'm the youngest of the family, to just say, you know what, I don't want to do it. I'm just going to go and play sports. So I asked my dad for 1 year. 1 year, I say, you know what, just give me 1 year and see what I can do. And if in 1 year you see that I don't want to be nobody, you just pull me out whatever I am. And that's what happened. In 1 year, I got signed by a major league team. And we knew that I could be a baseball player. So that was me. Is what I say. Mexico is way different than here. The opportunities in here to be a college guy and is still playing the sport is way higher than in Mexico.
Well, we're gonna pass it on to. El superintendente de aquí, Marcelo Cavazos, tiene unas palabras para ustedes.
Thank you. Primeramente, muchas gracias otra vez de nuevo para que ustedes que vinieron a acompañarnos hoy. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. Es muy importante que el distrito escolar esté abierto para las oportunidades que ustedes traen al distrito. So we're open as a school district for the opportunities and the dreams that your children have so that they can be successful. So, muy brevemente, las claves de hoy, de cuando todos hablaron aquí, when they all spoke here, the key was that the parents made a difference. Que los padres hicieron una diferencia en sus vidas, ¿verdad? Que no nada más lo dejaron a ver qué pasa. Porque muchas veces así decimos, que a ver qué pasa, right? Many times we hear that people say, well, let's see what happens with their education or their future. What you heard tonight is that their parents didn't say that. My parents didn't say that. A lot of parents here tonight don't say that. They said, we're going to make plans. Vamos a tener algo que vamos a perseguir. Vamos a tener metas para obtener. We're going to have goals that we can accomplish. So, brevemente, en el Distrito Escolar tenemos tres claves. We have three keys to success in our school district. One is academics. Two is attendance. And three is discipline. If you study hard, if you come to school and you respect and behave, just like you were talking about, so si tiene lo académico, la disciplina y la tendencia de existir a la escuela, venir a la escuela todos los días, van a tener éxito. So, como los padres que están aquí hoy esta noche, porque esta junta reunión es muy, muy, muy importante para los padres, no lo dejen para ver qué pasa. Don't leave it to chance as a parent. Be involved. So en el distrito escolar es muy importante que los padres tengan la información, that the parents have the information. to be successful. Porque muchas veces los padres dicen, pues yo los empujo, yo les doy el ejemplo, pero de ahí para allá, no sé qué más hacer. Many times parents that I speak to say, we give them the example, we talk to them, we tell them they have to have respect, but beyond that, I don't know what to do. So in Distrito Escolar, in our district, we have tools. Tenemos herramientas para que los padres puedan ayudar a los hijos. Y una muy importante, clave que tenemos, un herramienta, ¿verdad? One tool that we have that's very important is parent self-serve. Es un sistema del Distrito Escolar donde los padres pueden obtener la información de sus hijos. You can obtain the information about how your kids are doing in school, sobre la computadora, online, real time. So, ya no es posible de esperar 6 semanas. It's not no longer acceptable to wait 6 weeks para saber cómo están haciendo los estudiantes, cómo van progresando en las escuelas. To wait 6 weeks to see how the kids are doing is no longer something that's acceptable. So tenemos para que los padres puedan obtener esa información a cualquier tiempo que quieran. Porque los maestros ponen todos los grados y todos los si vienen a la escuela, todo está en la computadora. All the grades, attendance, discipline, todo está in the computer. So parents, you just have to log in para que obtener esa información. Y ese es muy poderoso. It's very powerful. Porque no quieren que en 6 semanas les hablen que sus hijos no han atendido la escuela. You don't want 6 weeks from now for somebody to call and say they haven't been to school. You want to know that today. Quieren saber eso hoy. So hoy esta noche, este es un brevemente comercial. Tonight, we have computer labs open so that all the parents here, if you're not signed up for parent self-serve to get the information that you need from your, about your kids, you can sign up tonight. So como padres, si quieren obtener esa información de cómo van progresando sus hijos en las escuelas, todos los días, no nada más en 6 semanas, 3 semanas. Hoy, esta noche, pueden ustedes registrarse para esa información. Tenemos las clases abiertas hoy esta noche para que se registren, para que obtengan esa información. So, muchas gracias de nuevo. Ok, se los agradecemos mucho. Sabemos que ustedes son parte de la comunidad de Arlington. Thank you very much. Muchas gracias, se lo agradecemos.